In this video, we will review the closed loop control of servo motor, stepper motor control and application to automation system. Let us discuss the closed loop control of servo motor. Servo motor is a special purpose motor which is used to control the machines with precision. Usually, the servo motor is used to control the angular motion among from 0 degree to 180 degree and 0 degree to 90 degree. The servo motor working principle is based on pulse width modulation technique. However, the pulse width modulation signal used to control the position rather than speed. The function of the servo motor is to receive a control signal that represents a desired output position of the servo shaft. It uses the position sensing device to determine the rotational position of the shaft. In a closed loop, servo motor control is usually 16-bit high-end microcontroller and external logic circuit. So this diagram shows the closed loop controller of servo motor. This diagram consists of encoder, counter, a microcontroller, digital to analog converter and power amplifier. The digital to analog converter can be handled by a conversion DAC or by using microcontroller pulse width modulation, that is PWM. In either case, the output of the signal is fed to a power stage which translates the analog signal into usable voltages and currents to drive the motor. Sequential encoder produce quadrature pulse train from which position or speed and direction of the motor. So, servo motor is based on servo mechanism and it is mainly used for position control. Consider a DC servo motor interfaced with microcontroller. The actual position of the motor is sensed with the sensor and it is compared with the desired position. If there exists a difference between the actual and desired position, the motor rotates either in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. The position of the rotor is controlled by the controller output. So, this is the flow chart for position control using servo motor. The microcontroller receives two data, that is, get the actual position value and get the desired position value. After that, check the difference between actual value and desired position value. If the difference value is zero, then stop the motor. If no means, check the carry bit value. If carry value is equal to 1, rotate the motor in right side direction, that is clockwise, until the difference reaches zero. Then stop the motor. If carry value is equal to 0, that is reset condition, rotate the motor in left side direction, that is anti-clockwise direction, until the difference reaches 0 and then stop the motor. So, in this way, the microcontroller controls the servo motor position. The next topic is interfacing of stepper motor using 8051 microcontroller. A stepper motor is widely used device that translates electrical pulses into mechanical movement. In applications such as disk drives, dot matrix printers, robotics, the stepper motor is used for position control. Stepper motors commonly have a permanent magnet rotor called shaft surrounded by a stator. The most common stepper motor have 4 windings that are paired with center tapped common terminals as shown here.
So totally four windings. This is A winding, this is B winding, this is C winding, and this is D winding. A and B windings are pair winding, one pair, and C and D are another pair. So here center tapped common terminal. So this is AB common terminal. So this is CD common terminal. The center tap allows a change of current direction in each of two coils when a winding is grounded, thereby resulting in a polarity change of the stator. The stepper motor shaft runs in a fixed repeatable movement. This movement is possible as a result of basic magnetic theory. The direction of rotation is decided by the stator poles. The stator poles are determined by the current sent through the coils. As the direction of the current is changed, the polarity is also changed, causing the reverse motion of the rotor. So this is the connection diagram of stepper motor with the 8051 microcontroller. This diagram shows the stepper motor. Okay, so this is stepper motor has four leads representing four stator windings. Okay, so this is two windings, this is another two windings. So totally four stator windings and two leads are common. Okay, two leads are common, that is center tapped leads. As the sequence of power is applied to each stator winding, the rotor will rotate in clockwise direction. Okay, to rotate motor in anti-clockwise direction, we have to excite motor in a reverse sequence. The excitation sequence for stepper motor has many changes due to change in winding connection. So this table shows the normal four-step sequence operation of stepper motor. Already you know, a stepper motor is a digital motor used to translate electrical pulses into mechanical movements. Motor shown in this circuit has two phases. So this is first phase, this is second phase with the center tapped winding. The center taps of these windings are connected to 12 volt power supply. Due to this, motor can be excited by grounding four terminals of the two windings. Motor can be rotated in steps by giving proper excitation sequence of these windings. The lower nibble of the port A of 8255 is used to generate excitation signals in the proper sequence. So, the total number of steps needed for complete one rotation or 360 degree is nothing but speed of the stepper motor, that is RPM, into steps per revolution divided by 60. This formula is used for to find out steps per second. So this table shows the typical excitation sequence. The given excitation sequence rotates the motor in clockwise direction. To rotate motor in anti-clockwise direction, we have to excite motor in a reverse sequence. See, already you know two phase windings. So this is first phase winding, this is second phase winding. So we have four terminals A, B, C and D. Okay, this is four step sequence. So four step means the motor starts from A point. Okay, then A to D indicates first step, then D to B, that is second step, then B to C, this is third step, then C to A, this is fourth step. So in clockwise direction. So A to D means in first step, okay, see this is step number one. In first step, A and D winding are present. So A value is equal to 1, D value is equal to 1, the remaining two winding values 0. In second step, from D point, the motor starts rotation from D to B. So D and B windings are present, that is B value 1 and D value 1, the remaining two winding values 0. Then in third step, the motor starts rotation from B to C. So B value and C value is equal to 1, the remaining two winding values equal to 0. Then in fourth step, the motor starts rotation from C to A. So here C winding value and A winding value is equal to 1. The remaining two winding values 0. Okay. Then thereafter, here the winding B position value 1. That is 2 power 0 is nothing but 1. So here winding D position value is 1. Then winding C position value 2. That is 2 power 1 is nothing but 2. Then winding B position value is 4. That is 2 power 2 is nothing but 4. Then winding A position value is 8. That is 2 power 3 is nothing but 8. So see here in step number 1. Here A value 1, D value 1. So here that is 8th bit, 8th position value and the first position value 1. So 8 plus 1, the equivalent value is 9. Okay, then in second step, that is winding B in position 4, then winding D in position 1. So 4 plus 1 is nothing but 5. Similarly, in third step, position 4 and position 2 values are 1. So 4 plus 2 is nothing but 6. Then in step number 4, winding A and winding C, that is 8th position and the second position values are equal to 1. So 8 plus 2 is nothing but 10. 10 equivalent hexadecimal value is A. The data for clockwise rotation 09, 05, 06 and 0A. So these data are stored at 9200, 9201, 9202 and 9203. Okay, so 9200 is nothing but starting address of data address. The next data is stored at 9201. The next data is stored at 9202. The last data, that is fourth step sequence data, is stored at 9203. Then in anti-clockwise direction, the data are 0A, 06, 05 and 09. So the first data is 0A. This data is stored at 9200. Second data is 06. This data is stored at 9201. Third data is 05. This data is stored at 9202. And last data, that is 09. This data is stored at 9203. So the clockwise direction, the data are 09, 05, 06, 0A. Anti-clockwise, the data are 0A, 06, 05 and 09. So this is the program for stepper motor interface with the 8051 microcontroller. So 80 is nothing but control register value. So this value is moved to accumulator register. Then 4003, this is port address. So this address is moved to data pointer. Then the accumulator value is stored in the specified address. Then 9200 is nothing but data address. This address is moved to data pointer. Then DPL value is moved to R1. DPH value is moved to R2. So DPL and DPH is nothing but data pointer, low order register and high order register. So DPL value is 00. This 00 is moved to R1. DPH is nothing but 92. This 92 is moved to R2. Here 4 indicates 4 step sequence. So here 4 datas are available. So this 4 is moved to register R0. Okay, then DPTR is nothing but 9200. 9200 content is moved to accumulator. So what is 9200 content? 9200 content is nothing but 09. This 09 is moved to accumulator register. Okay, then 4000, this address is moved to data pointer. Then the accumulator value is move to data pointer, that is the accumulator value is stored in 4000 address. Then L call delay, that is long call delay, call the delay program. So the control is automatically transferred to the delay program. Okay, here in delay program, three registers are used. One is R7 register, another one R6 register, another one R3 registers. In delay program, we can take any value. So here I am using 03, 0A and FF. These three datas are loaded into R7, R6 and R3. Then after loading, first decrement the R3 register value. So after decrement operation, set the R3 register content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not, means again decrement operation continue till register R3 reaches 00. Okay, after reaching 00, then move to the next instruction, that is decrement R6 register content. Check the R6 register content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not, means the same operation will repeat till it reaches 00. So after reaching 00, then it moves to the next instruction, that is a decrement R7 content. After decrementing, check the register content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not, means again the same operation will continue till the R7 register reaches 00. If R7 register reaches 00, then using return instruction, the control is automatically transferred in this location. Okay, that is increment R1. So R1 is nothing but DPL. So DPL means a data pointer, low order register value is incremented by 1. Already R1 value was 00. After execution of INC R1, the R1 value is 01. Okay. Then that value is loaded into DPL register. Then R2 register same, that is 92, that is moved to DPH. Now the data pointer addresses 9201. The next instruction, decrement R0 content. So R0 shows the total number of datas. Already one data outputted. So the stepper motor starts rotation, then it completes one step sequence. Okay, so for that reason here decrement R0 content, then check the R0 content whether reaches 0 or not. If not, means the controllers transfer to the specified address location, that is REP. So once again the data pointer register content is moved to accumulator register. Okay, data pointer is nothing but 9201. That content is moved to accumulator register. Okay, that is 9201 is nothing but 05, that is second step data. So that value is moved to accumulator register. Okay, then 4000 is moved to data pointer. Then accumulator value is moved to data pointer, that is 4000. Okay, again call delay program. So the control is automatically transferred here. After completing delay program, again it moves here, that is increment R1. Okay, then increment R1 means this time 9202. Okay, that value is loaded into DPL and DPH. Then decrement R0 content. Then check the R0 content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not, means the same operation will continue till R0 register reaches 00. So after reaching R0 register 0, that means the stepper motor completes one rotation. Using short jump instruction, the stepper motor will continuously rotating either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction with the help of yes jump instruction. So once the stepper motor starts operation, it continuously rotating either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. So this is the program for stepper motor interfacing with 8051 microcontroller. So this is the last topic, block diagram of washing machine control. A washing machine is an electronic device that is designed to wash laundry like cloth, sheet, towel and other beddings. It is made up of two steel tubes, which are the inner tube and outer tube, whose main role is to prevent water spilling to other parts of the machine. See the block diagram. So this is microcontroller unit. So the controller needs power supply. Then for reset operation, here power on reset block is also there. Then here user controls, communication circuit, then memory, then sensor and signal conditioning circuit, display unit, Then motor control. So this is buffer or driver circuit. Relay drivers and AC switching. So these are the blocks are available in all washing machines. Generally, the washing machine has various control knobs. They are load select knob, second one water inlet knob, third one mode select knob, fourth one program select knob. Let's see the first knob, that is load select knob. This knob select the number of cloth intended to be washed together and the amount of water required. It has three settings, that is high or medium or low. So these are the functions of load select knob. Then second knob, that is water inlet knob. This knob is used to select the hot water or cold water or mixed water which is required. So that is the function of water inlet knob. Then third knob, that is mode select knob. The washing machine can be operated in two modes. The first one is normal mode, the second one is save mode. In normal operation, the first operation, that is the cloths are washed, then the detergent is drained, the fresh water is poured, the cloth are rinsed, the water is drained, the moisture from cloth is taken out. So these are the operations under normal mode. In save mode, to save the detergent, for this mode is used. Then last one, that is program select knob. The program select knob is used to select the various settings like extra heavy, heavy, normal, light and delicate for washcloth of different kind. Then operations of washing machine. So different operation performed by the washing machines. They are fill, agitate, soak, drain and spin. Let's see the first operation, that is fill. The quantity of water is depends on the load setting, that is high load or medium load or low load, and it is filled through the inlet valve. Then second operation, agitate. The wash basket rotates in small steps simultaneously. The agitator rotates in the opposite direction in every small steps. After every steps, it waits for some second. Then third step, that is a soak. This operation is used to soak the detergent. In fourth step, that is a drain, water and detergent are taken out through the drain pipe. Then last step, that is spin. So in this operation, most of the moisture from cloth are taken out through holes in the inner metallic basket. So this is the interfacing diagram of washing machine with the 8051 microcontroller. Port 0, port 1 and port 2 are used. Port 0, two pins are used. One is third pin, another one fourth pin. Port 0, third pin is used for to collect hot water. Then port 0, fourth pin is used for to collect normal water through inlet valve. Then port 1, in port 1, four pins are used. Port 1, zeroth pin is used for heavy load operation. Port 1, first pin is used for normal load operation. Port 1 second pin is used for light load operation. Then port 1 third pin is used for delicate operation. Then second port. In second port, all pins are used. That is port 2 zeroth pin connected to LED. Then port 2 seventh pin connected to buzzer for making sound. For indication, then port 2 first pin connected to
hot water inlet, then port to second pin connected to cold water inlet, then port to third pin, that is high level, then port to fourth pin, medium level, then port to sixth pin, that is low level. That means pin number 2, pin number 4 and pin number 6 decide the speed of operation. If you want a high speed means, that is port 3 is connected, medium speed means pin number 4 is connected, low speed means pin number 6 is connected. In addition with pin number 5, that is port 2, pin number 5 is connected to drain, so that pin is act as drain pin. So this is about interfacing of washing machine with the 8051 microcontroller. This is control flow diagram of washing machine. So first ready operation, that is start the washing machine operation, then it moves to second step, that is fill water, then after that heat the water. After reaching required temperature, then the washing process starts. After washing, then rinse, then spin operation, then come to the end. Function completes, so come to the end. So this is the washing machine control flow diagram. So this is the flow chart for washing machine control. First start the operation and switch on the operation, switch on washing machine, fill the water, either hot water or normal water, then check program setting, whether 60 minutes operation or 45 minutes or 30 minutes or 25 minutes. For each operation, it takes 7 states. The first one is agitate, then second state drain, then again fill water, again agitate, again drain, then spinning operation, then buzzer for wash complete. So this is the flow chart for washing machine control. We have come to the end of this unit. We have also learnt all the topics present in this subject, EE8551 microprocessors and microcontrollers. It is such an easy subject. The only thing we have to do is understand and work out on it. Thank you.